Hypoplastic left heart syndrome is a condition in which the left ventricle is small. But in addition, the blood flow entering into the small left ventricle can be maldeveloped. This is the mitral valve. In addition, the blood flow exiting the left ventricle through the aortic valve can be impeded by an aortic valve that's not working properly. Importantly, in patients with hypoplastic left heart syndrome, the left ventricle has a thick layer of endocardial fibroelastosis, which lines the left ventricle and prevents it from working properly. In patients with hypoplastic left heart syndrome, the current treatment algorithm is a Fontan procedure or single ventricle palliation. However, many of these patients after the Fontan procedure can develop complications. And so we've devised a new strategy to help treat patients with hypoplastic left heart syndrome, and I'd like to explain how this strategy works. At the first stage operation, a Norwood procedure is performed in which all of the blood flow exiting the right and left side of the heart is directed towards the body. An additional source of blood flow to the lungs is provided from the right ventricle. This allows the circulation to stabilize until a child can grow. At approximately 4 to 6 months of age, we now proceed to the stage 2 approach. In the stage 2 procedure, the mitral valve and aortic valves are opened further, thereby allowing more blood flow into the small ventricle. In addition, endocardial fibroelastosis on the inside of the left ventricle is removed to allow the left ventricle to expand without any impeded flow. Removal of the endocardial fibroelastosis allows the left ventricle to relax and contract more easily. Finally, in order to promote more blood flow into the left ventricle, we have to restrict the atrial septum or prevent the blood flow from exiting the left atrium into the right atrium. We leave a small hole here to allow some decompression. Closure of the atrial septal defect allows blood flow returning from the lungs to go through the mitral valve and into the left ventricle and out of the aortic valve. This new flow pattern promotes growth of the small left ventricle, in some situations allowing it to return to a normal size. If the left ventricle responds appropriately to the staged ventricular recruitment procedure, one can use that left ventricle as a systemic pumping chamber. At the biventricular repair procedure, the connection between the aorta and the pulmonary artery can be removed and the aorta connected back to the body. The pulmonary artery is reconnected into the lungs. Now the blood flow returning back from the body goes to the lungs the way that it should. The blood flow coming back from the lungs goes into the new and improved left ventricle and out to the body. This is a more normal circulation, and in the appropriate patient, this can allow for normalization of the circulation. We believe that this procedure may be better than the Fontan since it avoids some of the complications associated with the Fontan procedure.